Brain Games.
Tales of Rongovia. This is the secret book of Rongovia, a place where everybody is out of sorts. And no wonder, because everything is out of time and place. To decipher the book's code, we will tell you tales, and you will tell us their mistakes. Let's begin. It is the year 1810, and the inseparable Brothers Grimm are collecting their collections of favorite fairy tales.
Say, Brother Jacob, let's begin with Once Upon a Time.
Yeah, good brother, and we will end with Happily Ever After.
Now, in collecting their stories, the Brothers Grimm could have used all of the following items except one. Which one of the following could they not have used? A printing press to publish the story of the repulsive Rumpelstiltskin. A lead pencil to tell the story of Hansel and Gretel. A keyboard typewriter to type Snow White. A goose quill pen to scribble away at Sleeping Beauty. Well, they could have used a quill pen. They had been used since ancient times, and the printing press had been around since the 1440s. As for the lead pencil, lead had been used to get the point across for some 350 years. But the one thing they could not have used was the typewriter. It wasn't on the market until 1874. And by then, the Brothers Grimm had met the Grim Reaper. And now we turn to 1271. The teenage Marco Polo is about to set sail on a journey from Venice to China.
Marco mia, cara mia.
After a painful parting, the marvelous Marco could have laid out only one of the following tools. Which one of the following items could have been used by Marco to help plot out his course to China? Could he have used radar equipment? A globe, a telescope, a magnetic compass. Well, he certainly could not have used radar. Radar is a modern device. The telescope was invented in the 1600s. As for the globe, absolutely not. In Marco's time, people believed the world was as flat as a pancake. But the one item Marco could have used was a magnetic compass. These had been around since the early 1100s. So, bon voyage, marvelous Marco. May you know east from west and our best to Kublai Khan. Now we turn to 1910 and observe the barefoot and lovely expressive dancer Isadora Duncan. Now, in expressing her expressiveness, she could have worn a tunic made out of all of the following fabrics except one. Which one could her costume not have been made of? Pure silk, 100% cotton, flowing nylon, or fine wool? Well, she could have had a costume of pure wool, silk, or cotton. All had been around for thousands of years. But nylon is a synthetic fabric, introduced in 1938 and made of synthetic, not natural fibers. Dance, Isadora, dance! And now, let us turn the page to colonial America. It is the year 1712, and young Benjamin Franklin is playing in his backyard. Now, which one of the following items could young Ben not have played with? A kite for flying, a toy train, a top for spinning, or brightly colored marbles? Well, available to colonial children were marbles, tops, and certainly kites for flying. But what the absolutely adorable Ben could not have played with was a toy train, because the first steam engine didn't chug-a-lug along until 1824. Sorry, Ben, you're on the wrong track. But anyway, it's time for bed. Remember, early to bed and early to rise. And now it's time to close the book of Rongovia. The sun is coming up, so it's time to say good night. I bid you farewell with a fond hello.
Brain Games. is now over.